This is the iPhone 15 Plus, and this is my review, my thoughts on it for the last 30 days, here on Simply Device. Hi there, I'm Mike Dixon. Welcome back to the channel. I want to talk about my time with this really good phone here, the iPhone 15 Plus. I almost wanted to title this video, Why Go Pro? And I'm like, no, I don't want to put that out. I do, but I don't. I don't want to put that kind of terminology out there about this phone. But I want to tell you my experience with this device. Right now, I'm shooting with my iPhone 13 Pro, and I just held it for the first time probably in 2+ weeks. And the size alone was like a wow. Okay, that's a small phone compared to this. I jumped right into the size talking about this phone. This is a big phone, bigger and feel in the hand kind of thing coming from, I have now the Pixel 8 Pro over here. Back there somewhere is a Motorola Edge Plus, which is, again, I'm not talking about the two different, I'm talking about the size of the phone. This is wide and tall. Kind of reminds me, reminiscent of my iPhone 8 Plus that I had a few years ago. But it's a good thing. You know, the screen is really, really gorgeous. I love this matte feel. A lot of people talk about it, and I'm right along with them. You know, it's so nice to have a phone that has this matte feeling on it, and then no fingerprints. I do keep it in a case on a regular basis, but I took it off for today's video. Overall, the phone, it's on iOS 17 point whatever. I feel that this is a significant upgrade coming from a Pro Max phone, but I'm sorry, Pro phone. I stand corrected, from a Pro phone to this. What I definitely feel is an upgrade. I don't know, is it the software? Is it the screen is really, really nice. I'm putting my code in here. For some reason it doesn't like my face right now. But day in and day out, I use this as more and more as a secondary work phone now. I'm planning on using it though for future YouTube ventures with it. It's still, you know, YouTube centric for my channel. That's why I picked up the 512 variant for storage. There's great deals. Hopefully this video gets out in a reasonable amount of time. Black Friday is days away. It's probably going to be great deals. And one other thing I want to talk about is, like I mentioned about the catchy term, why go pro? The extra camera, I'm going to be honest with you, I never utilized it. I never took advantage of what I felt was the extra camera. And I'm going to stick photos on here, somewhere around here in this part of the video. Photos and video, and it really takes great pictures, and you never would know. I would feel the difference between a pro model personally. I'm an Android guy. This is my only lead into the iOS Apple world. For me, and I stress for me, that just having the standard two-camera model works great. It takes really great pictures. The dynamic island I have on this model, now again, this that feature, that little island right there, is taken from last year's iPhone 14 Pro model. And I really thought it was a gimmick, but I do like having the it will show a little, icon in there, maybe YouTube, music. It shows the voice in there when I'm doing, a voice call. It's about when I'm using the speakers. Let's talk about, talk about the speakers. Absolutely really great speakers on this phone. I find myself listening to music on this phone, not really feeling the need to go get a speaker. I do use a speaker at work. As you can hear, the music, the sound is really, I can appreciate what this phone can provide for me, as far as if I didn't have my speaker, if I was lazy, half the time I am, go get my speaker to turn on the Bluetooth, and just want to listen to something in the background, I'm quite satisfied with the speakers on this phone. I really didn't get into the technical stuff on this. I really am trying to just tell you what I enjoy with the phone. There's not a really, I can't think of anything I don't enjoy using this phone. I have this paired with my Apple Watch 7, I believe. I really have a great experience using this phone. Battery life is phenomenal. This thing is really a beast. I've only one time killed the battery before going to bed. That's kind of like my benchmark. I take it off the charger, I go through my day, I put it back on a charger sometimes, and that's the thing with this battery. It's at 71% today. I took it off the charger about 6 this morning. And I did use this phone for various things, phone calls, text messages, again, work-related, a few emails, maybe a little, do the social thing, little Instagram reels, that kind of thing. I'm at 71%. This is not going to go on a charger tonight. This is going to just sit off to the side. The standby for the battery is, it will be the same when I pick it up in the morning. So I can highly recommend this phone if you don't mind a larger device, as far as I'm using the iPhone 13 Pro. I don't have another device to show you the size difference. But if you don't mind, and I would recommend if you it's everybody's to their liking or disliking about a large phone. I would recommend the larger phone for the battery life, for the screen real estate on it, for somebody that, like me, that has chunky, dried out thumbs. So I can't say enough about this phone. I'm going to hopefully do some videos. I'm working on some accessories. I'm going to try and talk about some interesting things. For this device, and I'm planning on shooting video and using this as part of my duo of iPhone 13 and iPhone 15 to shoot video for the channel, and I'm excited to do that, and I'll make sure I'll drop notes in there saying, hey, this was shot on which device. You're going to watch football games, you're going to watch TV shows, you're going to see these TV programs are going to be touting from the different carriers you know, we got the iPhone 15 Pro, you know, on sale, or buy, you know, come in and move your line of service, or come in if you're an existing customer and we'll give you a Pro. And that's fine. That's fine. Hey, I'm not knocking the Pro model. But what this is, what I feel enabled me to do was increase my storage. The base model, I believe, starts at 256 on the Pro model. This starts at 128. There's deals. This is the time to get deals. And I managed to increase the storage. I managed to get the larger phone, first off, versus the regular iPhone 15, and increase the storage to where I'm only going to pay $11, I believe, a month for this phone. And I also have coverage on it. I've got Apple Care. That's including the cost of Apple Care in that figure. So you could get yourself a really nice phone, a nice iPhone, and don't need to go Pro. Weigh out your options. See what the benefit is of not having to need that extra camera. Is there a financial gain or a bonus? You know, just not financial. Is there some other perk you're going to get out if you just go with the standard model and I'm recommending the Plus model? If you don't mind the larger size, if this, you know, some people, and I get it, some people don't like smaller phones, and I can completely understand where they're coming from. But I'm fine with this, and I can recommend this device. I want to wrap it up here. I'm Mike Dixon. This is Simply Your Device, and I'll see you guys in the next video.